फ्रेंड्स सब्सक्राइब कीजिए वाईफाई स्टडी चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट एग्जाम वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वाईफाई स्टडी चेंजिंग द वे ऑफ लर्निंग प्रेजेंट्स करंट अफेयर 2017 अक्टूबर फर्स्ट वीक इन इंग्लिश। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑल दोज इंपॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ द अक्टूबर। सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब सो दैट वी कैन प्रोवाइड यू मोर वीडियोज मोर कंटेंट फॉर अपकमिंग एग्जाम एंड होप यू विल डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू डाउनलोड जीके 24 एंड वोकैब 24 विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर इंग्लिश एंड जीके। दिस टू एप्लीकेशन विल डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू बूस्ट अप योर जीके एंड इंग्लिश। लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट इंटरनेशनल न्यूज फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल सेक्शन। ऑन विच डे इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ ओल्डर पर्सन इज सेलिब्रेटेड बाय यूएनओ। Okay, so what happened in the first week of the October? There is one International Day of Older Person that you need to remember the date first of all and the theme of this day also. So on the 1st October, International Day of Older Person is observed by United Nations. So your answer of this question is 1st of October. Okay, it was started in 1991 and the theme of this year is Stepping into the Future, Tapping the Talent, Contribution and Participation of the Older Person in Society. So this is the theme of the International Day of Older Person 2017. Okay, so your answer of this question is 1. Let's see another one. Which among the following Gulf countries imposed new sin tax on tobacco products, energy drinks and soft drinks? So recently what happened, there is one sin tax, okay, which was imposed on all those things which is not good for the health, like tobacco, energy drinks, soft drink. So UAE has begun collecting new sin tax on tobacco, energy drinks and soft drinks. Okay, on energy and tobacco 100% tax and soft drinks 50% tax will be levied. And new tax push come as UAE and other oil rich nations have struggled with low global energy prices. So your answer of this question is UAE. And as you know that capital of the UAE is Abu Dhabi. Okay. And dirham is the currency of this nation. Dirham. These two things are very important. You need to remember this. Let's see another question. With which country India will undertake a joint tiger census next month in their national park, forest and protected areas? So what will going to happen in the upcoming month that India and one of our neighboring country will going to take a joint tiger census? Okay, and the answer of your this question is Nepal. Nepal, India to conduct first joint tiger count. And friends, as you know that in India, there are nearby 50 tiger reserves. Okay. Tiger reserves in which and all these tiger reserves are governed by the Project Tiger, which is administered by the National Tiger Conservation Authority. Okay, National Tiger NTCA, National Tiger Conservation Authority, it is administered by them. And India is a home to 70% of the tigers in the world. In 2016, there are nearby 1400 tigers. Okay, which was increased to 1700 in 2011. And right now, there are nearby 2200 tigers in 2016. Okay. So these are the important things that you need to remember. Let's see another one. Which one of the following country will participate as a guest country at the World Summit of Governments? So friends, India picked as a guest country at the World Summit of Governments. The annual gathering is scheduled for 11 February 2018. And the honorary guest from India will join the notable list of speakers synonym with the World Government Summit to showcase the country's emerging economic growth, highlight valuable knowledge, skills, capabilities, elaborate on the country's unique culture according to the summit. So your answer of this question is India. India is picked as a guest country at the World Summit of Governments. What is the theme of the World Teachers Day 2017? Another very important question. Look friends, World Teachers Day and National Teachers Day, both are very important. Both dates are very important first of all. Okay, so if we talk about the World Teachers Day, it is celebrated on 5th of October. And if we talk about the National Teachers Day, okay, it is observed on 5th of September. Why 5th of September is chosen as the World National Teachers Day? Because it is a birth date of the Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. Okay, who is an Indian philosopher and statesman who was the first Vice President of India and the second President of India. Because of these achievements and he was a great teacher, his birth date is celebrated as a National Teachers Day. That is 5th of September. So you need to remember 5th of September and 5th of October also. October is a World Teachers Day. And what is the theme of this year? Okay, teaching in freedom, empowering teacher is the theme of this year, World Teachers Day. So teaching in freedom and empowering teachers, C is your answer. And this was started from the 1994. Let's see the national news now. Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman inaugurated the Prathan Shayok Bridge in which one of the following region? So as you know that recently there is a shuffling of the cabinet and right now which is our Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman is our Defense Minister. Okay, so Nirmala Sitharaman inaugurated the Pratham Shayok Bridge that will link Leh to Karakoram. So this bridge will going to link from Leh to Karakoram. providing connectivity on the strategically important Darbuk, Shayok, Dulit, Bag, Olit access for the military transport. Okay, so this is very important connectivity area for the military, and Nirmala Sitharaman inaugurated this event. And your answer to this question is JNK. It is in JNK. And as you know that Nirmala Sitharaman is an Indian politician currently serving as a defense minister, and she is also a member of Rajya Sabha for Karnataka. Okay, and previously he was served as a Minister of State for Finance and Corporate Affairs under the Ministry of Finance and the Minister for Commerce and Industry with independent charge. Okay, and prior to her work, she was also the national spokesperson for the Bharatiya Janata Party. Okay, so these are the important things that you need to remember. Let's see another one. So there are three statements, friends, you need to consider and you need to give the right one. To celebrate and promote women entrepreneurs and farmers in the organic sector from across India, third edition of the Women of India Organic Festival held in New Delhi. So this is the correct statement, friends. Okay, the theme of this year is good for women, good for India, good for you. Okay, this is also correct. And this festival is hosted by the Ministry of Agriculture. This is not the correct one because this festival is organized by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. And Shrimati Menaka Gandhi is the head of this ministry. And this ministry is promoting and hosted this event. So your answer of this question is 1 and 2. This is the third edition of the Women of India Organic Festival, which was held in New Delhi. So these are the things that you need to remember. Let's see another one. There are another three statements that you need to consider. First one is India has designated Zorampi land checkpost in Lamurine district of Mizoram as an authorized immigration checkpost for entry into or exit from India to or from Myanmar. Okay, second, India has designated Karvapuchla land checkpost in Longi district of Mizoram as an authorized checkpost for entry from India to from Bangladesh. And third one is India share a 1600 kilometer long boundary with Myanmar, which touches Arunachal, Naganen, Meghalaya and Mizoram. Okay, so these are the 3 points. Friends, your first statement is correct one because India has designed Zorampi land checkpost in the Mizoram as an entry and exit from the Myanmar to India. Okay, second one is also correct because there is another checkpost in the Mizoram which is connected between the India and Bangladesh. Third one is the wrong one. Okay, this is the correct one, that there is a 1600 kilometer long border with the Myanmar which touches Arunachal, Naganland and Mizoram and Manipur. Okay, not the Meghalaya. Meghalaya touches the boundary with the Bangladesh, not with the Myanmar actually. Okay, so your third one is the wrong one. So your answer of this question is A, only 1 and 2. Let's see another one. President Ramnath Kovind inaugurated the Shwak New Shirdi Airport in which one of the following city of Maharashtra? Okay, so President Kovind inaugurated Shirdi Airport. So there is another airport which is inaugurated by our President of India, Ramnath Kovind, recently inaugurated the Shavik New Shirdi Airport in Ahmednagar in the inaugural Alliance Air Commercial flight to Mumbai. So your answer of this question is Ahmednagar. This airport was opened in Ahmednagar. Okay, so you need to remember this one. And this is a small town in the western Maharashtra. It's a world famous pilgrim spot for the Samadhi temple of a 20th century saint known as Sai Baba, who is revered by all communities. So this is a Samadhi place of a very famous, world famous person, Sai Baba. Okay, so over that place, there is one important airport was made named by the name of Shirdi Airport. And this airport is in Ahmednagar. Let's see another one. Which one of the following state government launched a single click pension delivery scheme? Okay, so this is a scheme which is launched by the Madhya Pradesh. So your answer of this question is B. Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan launched single click pension delivery scheme wherein the money will go directly into the accounts of the beneficiaries. More than 35 lakh people of the state will be get benefited by this. Okay, and who is the governor of the Madhya Pradesh? Om Prakash Kohli. Om Prakash Kohli is the governor of the Madhya Pradesh right now. Okay, so these are the important things that you need to remember. First of all, governor, and another one is the CM name, that is Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Let's see another one. On which day International Day of Non-Violence is celebrated by UNO? So as you know that this is a very simple question. The third anniversary of the Swachh Bharat Mission celebrated as Swachh Bharat Divas is on 2nd October. And this 2nd of October is also celebrated as International Day of Nonviolence because of the birth date of the Mahatma Gandhi, father of our nation. Okay, so United Nations General Assembly has voted for this on 15 June 2007. So your answer of this question is B, that is 2nd of October. Which one of the foreign city became the first state capital to come up with an exclusive toilet for the transgender community? Another very important question, because over 5 months after the union government asked all states to allow transgender people to use any public toilet of their choice, Bhopal became the first state capital to come up with an exclusive toilets for the transgender community. So they made a exclusive toilets for the transgender communities. So because of that, Bhopal became the first state capital. So your answer to this question is C. Bhopal became the first state capital to come up with an exclusive toilet for the transgender community. Okay, and as we previously discussed, who is the chief minister of the MP? Shivraj Singh Chauhan, and the governor is Om Prakash Kohli. Let's see another one. At which one of the following place a tall bronze statue of Mahatma Gandhi has been established on the occasion of 148th birth anniversary? So as you know that recently 148th birth anniversary of the Mahatma Gandhi is celebrated, and Rajghat, the samadhi of the father of the nation, okay, in the capital of our country, New Delhi, okay, there is one statue is made over that place of the Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so Vice President of India Venkaiah Naidu inaugurated this statue, and your answer of this question is Rajghat. Rajghat is the place where Mahatma Gandhi statue for the first time has been developed. Let's see another one. In which city Global Entrepreneurship Summit 2017 to be held? Another very important question, friends, because Global Entrepreneurship Summit 2017 going to be held in Hyderabad. Okay, Hyderabad is your answer. So a high level delegation from the government of India and the United States meet at Niti Aayog to plan the 2017 Global Entrepreneurship Summit, going to be held in November at the Hyderabad International Convention Center in Hyderabad. Okay, so Niti Aayog, Government of India, United States, so these are the key people which is organizing this event. And this summit will be going to be inaugurated by our PM, that is Shri Narendra Modi, and advisor to the President, Ivanka Trump, okay, who leads the US delegation. Okay, and there's another important thing that you need to remember about the Niti Aayog. As you know, the Niti Aayog, the full form of the Niti Aayog is National Institution for Transforming India, and it is a Government of India policy think tank established by the NDA government to replace the Planning Commission, followed the top-down approach. Okay, so Planning Commission previously followed the top-down approach. So, but right now, Niti Aayog is doing? They are following the down-top approach. So this is the difference between both of them. Okay. And the Union Government announced the formation of Niti Aayog on 1st of January 2015. And the first meeting was held on 8th February 2015. Okay, and who is the ex-officio chairman? PM is our ex-officio chairman of the Niti Aayog. And the Governor Council consists of all state. The Governor, if we talk about the Governing Council, then it consists of all the Chief Minister of the state, Chief Minister of the Delhi and the Pondicherry, Lieutenant Governors of the Andaman and Nicobar, and the Vice Chairman nominated by the PM. And in addition to the full member, there are two part-time members also. And there are four official members and a chief executive officer. Okay, and there are some temporary members also from the leading universities and research institutions. So this is the governing council of the, a very strong governing council is made of the Niti Aayog. Okay, and who is the vice chairman? Rajiv Kumar is the vice chairman. Bibek Debroy, V.K. Saraswat, Ramesh Chand, Vinod Paul, all these are the members of the Niti Aayog. And who is the CEO? Abhitab Kant is the CEO of this organization right now. Okay, let's see another one. Who among the following has been chosen as a brand ambassador of the Swachh Andhra Mission in the Andhra Pradesh? Okay, so there is a recently what happened, taking the cue from the Prime Minister and the Modi Swachh Bharat Mission, Andhra Pradesh CM Chandrababu Naidu launched Swachh Andhra Mission on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti. Okay, and the ace shuttler PV Sindhu has been chosen as the brand ambassador of Swachh Andhra. Okay, join Naidu on this occasion. So your answer of this question is PV Sindhu has made the brand ambassador of the Swachh Andhra Mission. And if we talk about the who is the governor of the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, there is a single governor of the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. ESL Narasimhan is the governor of these two states. Let's see another one. Which of the following state has implemented no helmet, no petrol rule for two-wheelers riders to reduce the road accident death? Okay, so recently what happened, there is one rule made by one of our state. Okay, if you are not wearing a helmet on a two-wheeler, then you will not get a petrol. Okay, to reduce the road accident death. So this scheme was implemented by Andhra Pradesh. Your answer of this question is B. Okay, and Chandrababu has sanctioned rupees 10 crore for equipment to implement this rule. So let's see another one. Which one of the following state has launched Matru Purna स्कीम टू मीट द न्यूट्रिशन नीड ऑफ प्रेग्नेंट एंड लैक्टेटिंग वुमेन्स इन रूरल एरियाज. ओके, सो एज यू नो दैट देर इज अ लैक ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन आर कंट्री सॉइल, देर इज अ लैक ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन आर चिल्ड्रन ऑफ द नेशन. सो टू काउंटर अटैक दैट, वन ऑफ आर स्टेट हैज लॉन्च्ड ए स्कीम नोन एज मात्र महत्वपूर्ण स्कीम टू provide the nutritional need of the pregnant and the lactating woman in the rural areas. And the state which implemented this scheme is the Karnataka. So your answer of this question is D, that is Karnataka. Okay, under this program, pregnant and the lactating poor woman in the rural area will get one nutrition meal daily for 25 days in a month. Which country women police training center will get technical and financial assistance from government of India? So another very important question, the union cabinet chaired by RPM Shri Narendra Modi has given his ex post facto approval to the memorandum of understanding between India and Myanmar on upgradation of the women police training center at the Myanmar. Okay, this MOU was signed on 6th of September. So your answer of this question is D. Upgradation of the Women Police Training Center at the Yamatin, Myanmar will be going to take place. Okay, let's see another question. Resources in the Northeast Eastern region. So there is a one high committee which is made on the proper management of the water resources in the Northeastern region. So who is the head of that committee? So Government of India has constituted a high level committee for proper management of the water resources. Okay, proper management of the water resources in the Northeastern region under the chairmanship of Rajiv Kumar, and who is Rajiv Kumar? He is a vice chairman of Niti Aayog. Okay, so Rajiv Kumar is your answer. A is your answer. And this is a sequel to the PM Narendra Modi visit to Guwahati in August this year to review the flood situation and relief work in the northeastern states. So to see the proper water management in the northeastern region, this committee was made under the leadership of the Rajiv Kumar. Let's see another one. In which one of the following city a turtle sanctuary will be going to set up to protect the rich aquatic biodiversity of the river Ganga from escalating anthropogenic pressure? Okay, so there is one turtle sanctuary going to be set up in Allahabad. So your answer of this question is B. Allahabad is the state where turtle sanctuary will be going to be placed. Okay, and if we talk about the lifespan of a turtle, it varies greatly depending upon the species of the turtle. For example, a typical pet turtle, there is one pet turtle, and the lifespan of the typical pet turtle is nearby 10 to 80 years. And if we talk about the large species of the turtle, then they live nearby 100 years. And if we talk about the Guinness Book of World Records, turtles has the longest lifespan of up to 152 years. Okay, 152 years is the highest age of a turtle. Let's see another one. In which one of the following country, first ITI for Dibangas open? Divyangans. Okay, so as you know that there's a lack of opportunities, there's a lack of foundation, the foundation of the infrastructure which is for the, okay, Divyangs. Okay, there's a one city which is allowing ITI for Divyangans. So country's first ITI for Divyangas in Dibrugarh. Okay, so Dibrugarh is the place where the first ITI for Divyangas will be going to open. So the answer of this question is D. And where is the Dibrugarh? It is in Assam. Okay, and who is the chief minister? Sarbananda Sonowal is the chief minister of the Assam. So let's see another question. Which one of the following state has become the first state to allow the central direction to cut value tax on petrol and diesel? Okay, so recently what happened? The prices of the petrol and the diesel goes up, and the center, okay, recommend all the state to cut the VAT prices, to cut the VAT tax, to reduce the price of the petrol and diesel. So the first state to implement this scheme or this theory to reduce the VAT from the petrol and diesel is Gujarat. Okay, so D is your answer. Gujarat is the first state to slash VAT on the fuel prices. Okay, recently union government cut basic excise duty on the petrol and diesel by 2 rupees a liter. And so your answer of this question is D. And we are going to discuss more about this prices of the petrol and diesel also, friends. Okay, friends, okay, if we talk about the raw crude oil in Indian currency, then there is nearby 21 or 22 rupees per liter. Okay, this is the price of the raw crude oil. And if we do a basic refinery margin and landing cost, okay, refinery cost, then there is addition of nearby 3.35 rupees. Okay. So there is another cost, that is a margin transportation, freight, landing to dealers cost, which is of 2.50 rupees. Okay, so if we add all these prices, then the prices goes to nearby 28 rupees. Okay, after that there is a refining cost, there is a additional excise duty. If you heard about the excise duty, okay, the excise duty is of nearby 20 to 21 rupees. It will take this price to the nearby 50 rupees excise duty, and after that VAT is implemented. After that, okay, there is one petrol pump dealer commission is also added into it. After the 50 rupees, there is one petrol pump commission that is of 2.30 rupees, and after that, okay, after that nearby 25 to 27% tax is levied by the name of VAT. Okay, and that goes to nearby 13 to 15 rupees. And if this 30 to 15 rupees is added into the 55 or 60 rupees, then the price of the petrol goes to nearby 70 rupees. So this is the entire process of the prices of the crude oil. Okay, we can't do anything about these prices, friends. Okay, these are the very necessary prices that we should have to be take care of all about. But this VAT is the thing that can be managed by the state to cut down the prices, because they levy nearby 20 to 27% on the petrol and nearby 18% on the diesel. And this is the thing which take the prices from 50 rupees to the 70 rupees. Okay, so recently Gujarat slashes by the 2%. Let's see another question. There are three statements that you need to take care of about. Let's see the first one. Minister of Tourism is organizing a Paryatan Parv across the country from the 5th to 25th October 2017. This is the correct statement. Okay, don't need to learn about this. There is a one Paryatan Parv. Okay, obviously Paryatan Parv will be going to be organized by the Minister of Tourism. Let's see the second one. That program is being organized with the objective of showcasing the cultural diversity of the country and reinforcing the principle of tourism for all. Okay, this is also the correct one. Let's see another one. The Parv is being inaugurated at the Humayun Tomb, New Delhi. This is also the correct one. Okay, so your answer of this question is all of these. That is D is your answer. So the Minister of Tourism, in collaboration with the other cabinet ministers, organized a Paryatan Parv from the 5th to 25th October. So the program has been organized with the objective of drawing focus on the benefit of the tourism, showcasing the cultural diversity of the country and the reinforcing the principle of tourism for all. Okay, and this Parv has been inaugurated at the Humayun Tomb, New Delhi, by the Dr. Mahesh Sharma, Minister of State for Culture, Independent Charge for Culture. Okay, so your answer to this question is D, as I told you before. Let's see another one. There is another three statements that you need to take care of about. First is, the center launched a 6-year secure Himalaya project to ensure conservation of locally and globally significant biodiversity in the Himalayan ecosystem spread over 5 states in India. Okay, so center launched a 6-year secure program. Second is, the protection of snow leopard and other endangered species and their habitat is one of the key component of the project. This one is also right. This one is another, the correct one. Let's see the third one. The project called Secure Himalaya was launched in association with the United Nations Development Program. Okay, so this is the third one. So let's see the news first. Then after that, we are going to discuss about it. So the center launched a 6-year project to secure conservation of locally and globally significant biodiversity, land and forest resources in the high Himalaya ecosystem spread over the 4 states in India. Okay, so there is a one mistake that, okay, we didn't saw. This is the 4 state. So there are 4 state in the Himalayan region. This is the mistake. So your first one is the wrong one, and second and third is the right one. Okay. And the project Secure Himalaya was launched by the Union Environment Minister Harshvardhan in association with the UNDP, inaugurated on the Global Wildlife Program Conference. So your answer to this question is B. Let's see another one. Which one of the following state government approved the Mukhyamantri Samuhik Vivah Yojana Mass Marriage Scheme? So another scheme which is launched by the UP government. Okay, there is one mass marriage scheme. Lot of girls will be going to get married simultaneously. Okay, so this is the Mukhya Mantri Samuhik Vivah Yojana. This scheme was launched by Uttar Pradesh. Okay, and as you know that, who is the CM of the Uttar Pradesh right now? Yogi. Okay, is the CM of the right now, and who is the governor? Ram Naik is the governor of the UP right now. So let's see another one. What is the theme of India Water Week, which will be inaugurated by President on the October 10, 2017 in New Delhi? So this is the another question that you need to remember. There is the one India Water Week, which was inaugurated by President on 10th October in New Delhi. So what is the theme of that? Okay, so if we talk about the theme of this is Water and Energy for Inclusive Growth. This is the theme of this year. Water and Energy for Inclusive Growth. Okay, so this is another very important question. And who is the head of the Water Resource River Development Ganga Rejuvenation? Shri Nitin Gadkari. And who is the Union Minister of State for Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation? Shri Arjun Ram Meghwal. Okay, Arjun Ram Meghwal is the Union Minister of State for Water Resources. So let's see another question. In which city Rashtriya Sanskriti Mahotsav RSM 2017 held? सो अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज डॉक्टर महेश शर्मा इनॉग्रेटेड द राष्ट्रीय संस्कृति महोत्सव. ओके दिस वॉज स्टार्टेड इन द अहमदाबाद. दिस इज द वर्ल्ड फर्स्ट ओके हेरिटेज सिटी अहमदाबाद गुजरात. इंडियाज फर्स्ट ओके नॉट अमॉन्ग द वर्ल्ड दिस इज इंडियाज फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज सिटी. सो द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज सी अहमदाबाद. ओके दिस वॉज स्टार्टेड इन अहमदाबाद. सो मिस सुजाता प्रसाद एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी मिनिस्टर ऑफ कल्चर एड्रेसिंग द मीडिया पर्सन इन द अहमदाबाद गुजरात सेड द राष्ट्रीय संस्कृति महोत्सव वॉज कंसीव्ड बाय द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कल्चर इन द ईयर 2015 एंड आफ्टर द ग्रैंड सक्सेस ऑफ द फर्स्ट राष्ट्रीय संस्कृत महोत्सव इन 2015 द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कल्चर डिसाइडेड टू ऑर्गेनाइज इट विद एन इंटेंट टू शोकेस द रिच कल्चरल हेरिटेज ऑफ द कंट्री इन ऑल इट्स रिच एंड वेरिड डायमेंशंस. ओके लाइक देर आर डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस दैट वी नीड टू शोकेस द वर्ल्ड लाइक हैंडीक्राफ्ट कुजीन पेंटिंग कल्चर ओके स्कल्पचर फोटोग्राफी. So all these are the thing, all these things are showcased in this event. Let's see another one. There are three statements again that you need to remember. Let's see the first one. Minister of External Affairs in collaboration with the Minister of Culture will present the first ever Asian India Music Festival in New Delhi. And let's see the second one. The festival is organized to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Asian India Dialogue Relation. And the third one is the theme of this commemorative year is Shared Values, Common Destiny. This is the third one. Okay, so all these three statements is the correct one, friends, because this one is also correct. Okay, second one is also correct. It is the 25th anniversary and the third one is also correct, the theme of this year. So your answer of this one is 1, 2, 3. D is your answer. Okay, and it was inaugurated in Purana Kila in New Delhi. And this is the 25th anniversary of the Indian-Asian Dialogue Relation. Let's see another one. In which city a three-day global medical conference aimed at engaging industry and academic leaders to discuss current amid medical needs held. So three-day global medical conference began in Chandigarh. So your answer of this question is C. Okay, three-day international conference aimed at engaging industry and academic leaders to discuss current medical needs began at CSIR. Okay, CSIR, Institute of Medical Microbial Technology in Chandigarh. So CSIR IMTech is a premium microbial institute under the aegis of the Union Ministry of Science and Technology. Okay, and the aim of this conference is to engage industry and academic leaders to discuss current unmet medical needs globally. Okay, and this conference was held in Chandigarh. In which city ISRO will set up a research center for startup, academics, environmentalists and entrepreneurs of Northeast states. Okay, so this ISRO will going to set up a research center at in Guwahati. So your answer of this question is E. Okay, they will be going to set up in Guwahati. This is for startups, academics, environmentalists, entrepreneurs. Okay, and as you know that ISRO is a space agency of the government of India headquartered in the city of Bangalore. So where is the headquarter of ISRO? It is in Bangalore. And who is the founder of this organization? Vikram Sarabhai was the founder of this organization and it was founded on 15th August 1969. And who is the current director? Kiran Kumar is the current director of this organization. So these are the things that you need to remember. Now let's see the business news. Which one of the following telecom company has called off plan to merge its wireless business with rival Aircel, citing legal and regulatory uncertainties? So recently what happened? Reliance Communications has called off its plan to merge with the Aircel. Okay, so your answer of this question is Reliance Communications. Let's see another one. Which one of the following rating agencies has lowered India's economic growth forecast for the current fiscal to 6.9% from 7.4%? So Finch Rating has lowered India's economic growth. Okay, so because of the demonetization, because of the recently this GST plans, India's growth forecast was lowered by different agencies. Okay, so this 7.4 to 6.9 was did by Finch. So your answer of this question is E. Okay, Finch lowered India's growth forecast to 6.9. And if we talk about the ADB, then ADB lowered India's forecast from 7.4 to 7%. Okay, not 6.9%. 6.9% is forecasted by Finch and 7% is by ADB. And India itself posted 7.1% growth in 2016-17. Let's another one. At which rank India First IFSC has been featured in the latest September 2017 edition of Global Financial Center Index 22 GFCI London. Okay, so India First IFSC has been featured at the 10th place in the latest September 2017 edition of the Global Financial Center Index 22 in London. So, your answer of this question is 10. Okay, India is on 10th ranking. Okay, the Gandhinagar-based IFSC has ranked ahead of the other leading financial hubs like Luxembourg, Seoul, Beijing. Okay, let's see another one. the first shipment of US crude oil to India arrived at which one of the following port? So as you know that for the India and US made an agreement MOU over the oil, crude oil. So the first shipment of the US crude oil to India arrived at the Paradip port in Odisha. Okay, so where is the Paradip port? It is in Odisha as a part of 2 million barrel contracted by India. So there is a deal of 2 million barrels and the first shipment of the US crude oil came to India. Okay, let's see another one. There are four organizations. Which among the following bank will co-finance a loan for India to improve power transmission network and expand the use of solar and wind energy? So there are two banks that will be going to co-finance a loan for India. Okay, so your answer of this question is AIIB and the ADB. These are the two banks. So your answer of this question is A, 1 and 4. There's a two bank that will going to finance $100 million loan for India for power sector. Okay, and as you know that ADB, about ADB, we previously discussed so many times about the ADB. Its headquarter is in Manila. Okay, and there are a lot of different things about the ADB. So now what we are going to do, we are going to discuss about AIIB. Its headquarter is in Beijing. Okay, this is also another very important bank. Okay, and it is a multilateral development bank that aims to support the building of infrastructure in the Asia Pacific region. Okay, and that currently has 56 member states while another 24 are prospective members for a total of 80 approved members. And there are 56 members as I told you and 24 prospective members. Official language is English and who is the president? Jin Liquin is the president of this organization right now. Okay, let's see another question. According to the revised monetary policy, what is the new repo rate? So the RBI keeps repo rate, reverse repo rate unchanged. Okay, what is the repo rate? 6% is the repo rate and 5.75% is the reverse repo rate right now. MSF rate is 6.25%, bank rate is 6.25%, CRR is 4%, SLR is 19.5%. Okay, so these are the very important rates that you need to remember for your upcoming exam. And what happened in this question, we asked you about the new repo rate. So what is the new repo rate? It is unchanged and it is of 6%. Let's see another one. Which one of the following countries signed a LOC agreement with India for its infrastructure and social sector development? So Bangladesh signed a $4.5 billion third line of credit agreement with India for its infrastructure and social sector development. So your answer of this question is C. Okay. With which bank India signed the finance contract for lending of ₹300 billion for Bangalore Metro Rail Project Phase 2? So as you know that Bangalore Metro Rail Project 2 will be going to be started in the upcoming month and India signed €300 million finance contract with the European Investment Bank. So your answer of this question is A. Okay, India signed with the European Investment Bank for Bangalore Metro Rail Project Phase 2. Okay. And basically this is jointly financed by the European Bank and AIIB. Listen, another question. Who among the following is the chairman of a high-level task force on public credit registry for India formed by RBI? So friends, this is another question which will ask you about the chairman of a high-level task force on public credit registry. So your answer of this question is Yashwant M. Doshle. Your A is your answer. Okay, so here we can see the news. RBI has formed a high-level task force on public credit registry for India. The task force has been constituted under the chairmanship of Yashwant M. Okay, so you can say here the answer and your answer with this question is A. Let's see another one. Which one of the following company has launched Neo as servicing bot for Twitter that uses artificial intelligence for customer service? Okay, so this is another question which is about the bank, which is about the new service. Okay, so your answer of this question is HDFC Bank Insurance Company has launched Neo. And what is this Neo? It is a servicing bot for Twitter that uses artificial intelligence for customer service. So your answer of this question is A. And as you know that, where is the headquarter of the HDFC Bank? It is in Mumbai. Let's see another one. Which from the following bank has acquired payment wallet free charge for ₹373 crore? Okay, so this, as you know that free charge is a payment, okay, payment wallet, and Axis Bank acquires free charge. So your answer of this question is C. Axis Bank has acquired free charge of ₹373 crore in an all cash deal. Sangram Singh has been appointed as a CEO of Free Charge Payment Technologies Private Limited. Let's see another one. Which one of the following bank has entered into an MOU with HPCL for enabling all HPCL retail outlets with Bheem UPI merchant solution? So recently what happened? Vijaya Bank has entered into an MOU with the Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited for enabling all HPCL retail outlet with the Bheem. Okay, so to boost up the government application that is the Bheem, they did this. So your answer to this question is Vijaya Bank. And where is the headquarter of the Vijaya Bank? It is in Bangalore. Now we are going to see the appointment questions. Which one of the following has been appointed as a lieutenant governor for Andaman and Nicobar Islands? So friends, right now what happened? There are many different governors appointed by the President of India. So let's go and learn all these appointments. So let's see the first one, that is B.D. Mishra. B.D. Mishra is appointed as the governor of Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, Satyapal Malik as appointed as governor of Bihar. Banwarilal Purohit appointed as a governor of Tamil Nadu. Then Jagdish Mukhi is appointed as a governor of Assam. Then Ganga Prasad appointed as a governor of Meghalaya. And Admiral Devendra Kumar Joshi appointed as a governor of Andaman and Nicobar Island. So your answer of this question is Admiral Devendra Kumar Joshi. D is your answer. Let's see another question. Who among the following has been appointed as a chairman of a commission to examine the subcategorization of other backward classes? Okay, so recently there is a chairman of a commission appointed by the government and okay, so let's see the example of this. The president on 2/10/2017 exercise of a power conferred by the Article 240, the Constitution appointed a commission to examine the subcategorization of the other backward classes. Okay, so President of India appointed a commission to examine subcategorization of the OBC. As you know that this is a very hot-shot topic about the categorization of the OBCs, and the President of India appointed a commission. Okay, and who is the head of this commission? So chairman of this commission is the G. Rohini. Okay, so C is your answer. That's another one. Who among the following has been appointed as a chairman of Process Plant and Machinery Association of India? So Yatinder Paul Singh Suri has elected as a PPMAI chairman. Okay, so your answer to this question is B. So the Process Plant and Machinery Association of India has elected Yatinder Paul Singh Suri as its new chairman. Suri is currently working as an MD and India head of a Finland-based stainless steel major, Otto Kumpu. So let's see another question. Who among the following has been appointed as a new chairman of SBI? So this is a very important question. Friends, as you know that, okay, Arundhati Bhattacharya completed his tenure, and right now Rajneesh Kumar is appointed as a new SBI chairman, and he is the 25th chairman of the country's largest lender, succeeding Arundhati Bhattacharya, who had retired on 6 October. So your answer of this question is B, Rajneesh Kumar. Let's see another question. Which one of the following country has chosen its new prime minister, bringing into focus the potential implementation for diplomatic relation with North Korea as well as neighboring Russia and China? So friends, let's see the news of this. The Mongolian legislature installed a new prime minister, bringing into the focus the potential implementation for the diplomatic relation with the North Korea as well as Russia and China. Okay, so Kuroso Ukna, the previous deputy minister, is appointed as a present new prime minister of the Mongolia. So your answer of this question is B. That's another one. Who among the following is appointed as the next ambassador of India to the Republic of Macedonia? Okay, so Pooja Kapoor is next ambassador of India to the Republic of Macedonia. Okay, so let's see the answer of your question is C is your answer. Now let's see some awards question. Which one of the following company awarded for leading in marketing of composite made from municipal solid waste? Okay, so recently what happened? FB Group gets Swachhta Award for voluntary citizen action. Okay, so your answer of this question is Fertilizers Cooperative. Kribocho has conferred the Swachhta Award by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs on the occasion of 3rd anniversary of a launch of Swachh Bharat Mission for leading in marketing of composite made from the municipal solid waste. So your answer of this question is E. Okay, so let's go to another question. Which among the following temples has been adjudged the cleanest iconic place in the country under the Swachhta Hi Seva program? So friends, as you know that Meenakshi temple in Madurai has been adjudged the cleanest iconic place in the country under the Swachhta Hi Seva program. So your answer of this question is A is your answer, Meenakshi temple. Okay, as you know that Meenakshi temple is in Madurai, and this is a very famous place. Okay, so let's go to the another question. You need to consider the three options, friends. Nobel Assembly has decided to award a 2017 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine jointly to the Jeffrey Michael and Michael W. Young. The award will be given to them for their discoveries of molecular mechanism controlling the circadian rhythm. And the first Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine was awarded in 1901 to the German physiologist Armin von Behring. So these are the three statements, friends, and let's see the news first. 2017 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine jointly given to Jeffrey, then Michael M. Young. So this is the first one is the correct statement. Okay, and second one is also correct, and third one is also correct. Okay, so your answer of this question is D. D is your correct answer. Let's see another one. Rainer Wissing, Kip Thorne and Barry Barish won the Nobel Prize in Physics for which one of the following work? So, three American physicists has won the Nobel Prize in Physics for the first observation of the gravitational waves. Okay, so three American got this award for the observation of gravitational waves. Let's see another one. Which among the following ministers has been adjudged as the best department for its contribution during the Swachhta Pakhwada? Okay, so Minister of Health adjudged as the best for the Swachhta Pakhwada receives award. So, your answer of this question is Health and Family Welfare. So, Minister of Health and Family Welfare has been adjudged as the best department for its contribution towards the Swachhta Pakhwada, an inter-ministry initiative of Swachhta Bharat Mission, Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Let's see the another question. Who among the following has been chosen for the prestigious Bharat Ratna Pandit Bhimsen Joshi Award? So, recently what happened? Classical singer Manik Bhinde chosen for the Bhimsen Joshi Award. Okay, so your answer of this question is C. Let's see another one. Jacques Dubochet, Frank and Richard has won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for which one of the following work? So recently the Nobel Prize was announced and these three person got this award for working over the model of biological molecules. So D is your answer. Okay, they are trying to improve the image made of biological molecules. Okay, they developed a technique called Cairo Electron Microscopy, Cairo EM, which amplifies the process for looking at the machinery of life. Okay, so let's see another one. Who among the following has been selected for the Teaching Innovator Award 2016? So, IIM Bangalore Professor P.C. Narayan, a faculty from the Finance and Accounting area, has been selected for the Teaching Innovator Award 2016 by the Minister of HRD, Government of India. Okay, so your answer of this question is Narayan. So, D is your answer. Let's see another one. Who among the following has won Nobel Literature Prize 2017? So, British author Kazuo Ishiguro, best known for his novel The Remains of the Day, has won the Nobel Literature Prize on 5th of October. So, your answer of this question is C. Okay, in novels of great emotional force has covered the abyss beneath our illiteracy sense of connection within the world. Okay, the Academy wrote in the citation. Let's see another one. Who among the following will be posthumously awarded the annual Anna Politkovskaya Award? So the slain journalist and activist Gauri Lankesh will be the posthumously awarded the annual Anna Award, an award for woman human rights defender for war and conflict zone for her fearless journalism. Okay, so the award has been conferred by the International Human Rights Organization Reach All Women in War. So your answer of this question is Gauri Lankesh. Who among the following has been awarded by the Nobel Peace Prize 2017? So friends, if we talk about the Nobel Peace Prize, this award was given to International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapon, ICAN, a coalition of non-government organization from over 100 countries. Okay, so your answer of this question is B. International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapon got the Nobel Peace Prize for 2017. Now let's see some sports question. Who among the following player won Malaysian Grand Prix at the Sepang Circuit? So, a commanding drive from the Red Bull Max Verstappen saw him sounding beat 3-time world champion Lewis Hamilton to win Malaysian Grand Prix. Okay, so this time Lewis Hamilton got defeated by the Max. So, your answer of this question is Max Verstappen. Who among the following has been appointed as the next brand ambassador to India, to the Republic of Macedonia? So, as we previously discussed, and your answer of this question is C, Pooja Kapoor. Okay, appointed as the ambassador of India to the Macedonia. And if we talk about this sports question, okay, so Pooja Kaiden created history as she banged India's maiden gold medal at the World Wushu Championship. Okay, so Pooja Kaiden created history as she got the World Wushu Championship gold medal. So friends, these are the important questions from the first week of the October. Hope you like it and you will definitely going to subscribe us. And these questions will definitely going to help you your upcoming exam. So friends, thank you and all the best.